We did it. We have our first ever channel sponsor. And our sponsor is VRWave. 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 And they sent me the Halo head strap. And when I received that email, I was shocked because I had already owned the Halo head strap. And literally the night before I got their email, I was recommending this head strap to a stranger on Reddit. And here's why I am an evangelist for the Halo head strap. First of all, super easy to put on. I have a big head, so every time I let my friends borrow the head strap, you know, you gotta adjust the size. And so that is super cool. But I think the biggest feature is that it doesn't pull down on your face like other headsets. So with other headsets, and this is especially if you are East Asian like me and not well endowed with super high cheekbones, the way they rest on your face, it pulls everything down. And I have this irrational fear that if I spend long enough in a headset, eventually I will get wrinkles, permanent VR headset wrinkles that make my face look like this. So I tried out a few head straps, and I went through the original Oculus headset, a knockoff Elite head strap on Amazon, and then the actual Elite head strap on from the Oculus store. But none of those worked for me until I found the Halo head strap. And this works particularly well because the Halo head strap distributes the weight on top of your head like a halo. And if you hear a lot more structural support here than my soft and flat cheekbones, so that is why it's just super comfortable to wear, and I can wear it for so much longer than any anyway, that is my spiel for VRWave's head strap. It, compared to Oculus' head strap, it's super affordable, only about $30. I will put the exact price here and more information in the description box down below. And yeah, so now let's send you to the rest of the video. Alright, here's my high-tech portal, and off you go. You must be the new shipment. So how did you get here? Well, it looks like it was some sort of accident because you no longer have your legs or your arms. But you do have this really nice puffy vest, so it couldn't have been that bad of a death, right? Well, now that you're here, we will give you the perfect makeover. So you will be an angel like me. So you got a nice white puffy vest, that's a place to start. But you're going to need the rest of the outfit. So let's start with... Do you mind if I add some sparkles to your face? Awesome. Alright, let me go get my sparkles. Where did I put them? I put them over here. Alright, cool. So sparkles. How about on the nose, on the cheeks, and about everywhere. Yes, sparkles everywhere. So let's get some sparkles in. On the nose, down the nose, down the nose, and on the cheeks, this cheek. Sides of the face. Get your sparkles on the sides of the face. And let's get some on the back of the head too. Alright. Perfect. Now do some sparkles across the eyes. So can you close your eyes for me? Just close your eyes. Perfect. All right, keep them closed. All right, close again. Okay, perfect. So now that you have your sparkles, let's see. What else should we do? I know, we'll give you some glow. So, let me go get my glow. So in here, in this box, I have glow in the form of, you might be familiar with this. This will provide a glow, and then I will put it inside you, so you can glow like me. So, this requires a little bit of a startup. Here we go. Here's some glow. You sucked out the glow. Now let's do that one more time. Charge up the glow. Get that glow charged up. This one's kind of difficult. There we go. Get that glow in you. There we go. Now you have plenty of glow. Now, we want to make sure that your outfit fits really well, because you only get because we don't really grow. We do glow in heaven, but we don't grow. So we have one outfit and we wear it for the rest of the time because it's going to be the perfect outfit. So I'm going to take your exact measurements. So this should be easy because you don't have your arms or legs, so I think I can get off work early. You do have a head, and you will get a fancy halo like I do. So, let's start. Well, let's start by measuring everything else. A halo doesn't just sit on the forehead. It really needs to complement the rest of your face. So, let's make sure it's proportionate. So, we're going to start by measuring your nose. Alright, I'm going to get close. And 3-inch nose. Nose tip to lips, about 1 inch. Lips to chin. One inch now across the face. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 inches. I'm gonna come and measure the side of your face. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, I hope the other side is the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Awesome. And your wings are kind of small right now, but don't worry, those do grow. But I'm gonna go around and measure them, okay? Alright. So it looks like They are 1, 2, 3 inches each, so you have about a 6-inch wingspan. That's very cute, but it will get bigger. Alright, now we're going to measure around the head. So I'm gonna start here, and then go around. You have a 22-inch head circumference. That's very impressive. You must be very smart. Alright, now let's measure your eyebrows. Those are very important because your halo has to match your eyebrows. God forbid they don't. Alright, 3 inches on this side, 3 inches on this side. Inches. Now I'm gonna measure the iris of your eyes, so I want you to keep your eyes open, okay? Alright, keep your eyes open. Open, open, open. Okay, you can blink. Alright, now open them again. Keep them open, keep them open. And close. Alright, perfect. Now I'm gonna measure torso. Okay. Down here. Perfect. Alright. Alright. Just going to adjust the light in your eyes with my invisible knob. Oh, that's too much. And change the color a bit. Add some more gold. And you look perfect. Alright, now off you go. Enjoy your time here and maybe I'll see you.